shop is straight down this way. There'll be a sign in your ear, straight down this
way. Oh, dang. Oh.
I got it set up. Okay. It's taping already.
Is it taping? All right.
And you will be right this way.
Stand right.
Oh, down. Sorry.
And this will be yours.
Welcome, Dylan. I apologize for the confusion and rushing you in, but with the first order right outside, we have to make sure that you were the ones we were looking for. Rest assured, though, you are safe now. So go ahead and take a look around at our workshop. I am. It doesn't look like much. It's a bit dark and dusty and cluttered everywhere. But to us, this is all we have. And to us, it's home. Oh, allow me to introduce ourselves. Here I have Kevin. This is Joanna. My name is Lizzie, and we humbly call ourselves the Gatherers. We have dedicated our lives to this dangerous task. In order to collect this scrap metal for you, we have traveled to planets throughout the galaxy, from the fallen temples of Jeddah to the ashes of Malachor and even the dark forests of Kashyyyk. Wow. We go through all of this trouble in order to preserve our past and to ensure our futures. Because, well, as you might have seen outside, we are in troubling times. There is a conflict between the Resistance and the First Order, and it has been brought all the way to the outer rim here in the two, and there's been a call for help sent throughout the galaxy, but in the past we had legends like Luke Skywalker answer that call. You all know who Luke Skywalker is, right?
Oh, yeah.
Science is a little concerning. It's a really long story anyways, but now there are whispers of a new hero, Rey. She is our spark of hope, and like Luke and Rey, you have answered that call for help as well. That's why you're here. But I believe you're also here for something else.
Ooh.
I believe you're here for this.
Ooh.
The lightsaber. Elegant and powerful, the lightsaber is a direct connection between its wielder and the Force. It is a reflection of its wielder. It has been held by some of our greatest heroes and their darkest foes. And now building a lightsaber is a lost and ancient art form, but it's an art form pass on to all of you today. And in order to build a lightsaber, it begins with something small but very powerful. It begins with the kyber crystal. The kyber crystal is the heart of your lightsaber. It will magnify and intensify the powers of the Force, so much so that the color of your crystal will determine the color that your blade emits. And throughout our travels in the galaxy, we've been able to gather four colors for you to choose from. And as you can see with the symbol of the Empire behind us, it was not an easy task, but I'll start with our first to offer, blue. Once wielded by Master Obi-Wan Kenobi, his apprentice Anakin Skywalker, and now by Rey, our spark of hope. Green, held by Qui-Gon Jinn, Ahsoka Tano, Luke Skywalker, and Master Yoda. Violet, beautiful and rare, once wielded by Master Mace Windu himself.
Wow.
Red. Some may say it is the crystal of power. It's been held by Darth Vader, Darth Maul, Asajj Ventress, and now it is held by Kylo Ren. Like those legends once did, it is now time for you building to choose your Kylo crystal. So reach out into the Force and feel the vibration of the crystal that calls to you. That crystal will give you balance, and in times of despair, it will be your center. Once you have chosen your crystal, place it and leave it on the green plates in front of you to keep them stable in the time being. Wonderful choices. Get about half of what you see in front of you, so great health and calm. Lastly, you'll choose one set of matching activation plates. Now I will be guiding you through this build, and my fellow gatherers are here to help us out along the way. So I have one question for all of you. Are you ready to build a lightsaber?
Yes.
Alright, let's build. Go ahead and take your chassis from the left hand side and hold it with the oval vents on the top half. In the center of that chassis, there is a crystal chamber, and the ceiling of that chamber near the vents is a springy pad. Take your crystal from the either end and push it up into the center of that ceiling and using your crystal. Now you want your crystal to stand straight up and down, locked into place inside that chamber. When the crystal is initially inserted, you should hear a slight hum from your chassis, and the crystal and the vents should continue to glow the color of your crystal. If neither of those things happen or you'd like assistance, let us know. Once your crystal is standing straight up and down and glowing, raise your chassis to show that we're ready for the next step. Alright, looks like you're good at this. We're going to go ahead and move on to section 5. In section 5, choose one set of matching activation plates. Once you have chosen your matching set, look on the inside of those pieces. One will have a red square in the corner, the other will have a blue rectangle, and those are going to match up. Red square directly on top of red square, covering one half of the crystal, and blue rectangle directly on top of blue rectangle. Once you have both pieces on, find your activation switch and slide that piece up toward the vent of your hand. You should hear a misfire when you try to activate, which is a good sound for right now because you need to hear that song. So if you do not hear a misfire when you slide that switch toward the vent, please let us know before you move on. Once you have heard that misfire, we are going to move on to sections 1 and 2. Sections 1 and 2, you're going to choose two of the four seats. You can choose any two of those four, and you can mix and match however you like, any combination, one for the top and one for the bottom. However, there is one rule. And if I could have you all look up here for a demonstration, on one end of each seat, there will be a wide receiver band with a line on the inside. That is the only end of your seat that is going to go into your chassis first. You will then do a firm continuous twist into your activation plate so it does not fall off to your chassis. You're going to do this twice, one for the top where the vents are and one for the bottom with the solid end. Once again, any two of the four sleeves with sections 1 and 2, as long as the wire with your raised band of the sleeve goes in first,
sometimes
you're
like,
you'll end up with something like this with one sleeve on either end of the chassis. Neither of them should be moving or leaving from your chassis.
Thank you. Yes.
To touch it? Oh, thank you. Oh, wow.